I think it's the largest collection in the world, actually, and almost 10,000 brains that were collected from 1945 to early 1980s.
Brilliant thing that they did back then was when they finished the autopsy, they kept the brain, they kept the material that they have examined and put it up on the shelf and said, okay, maybe in a long time from now, 50 years, maybe even more, someone will come and know more about the brain than we do now.
There were no people from the outside who were asking questions about what went on in these state institutions. Patients in psychiatry had very few rights. You could get treated without saying yes to that particular treatment. And patients were seen as not as equal to other Danes at the time.
Debate has basically settled down and say, okay, this is a very impressive and a very useful scientific research if you want to know more about mental disease.
These are brains from patients from many years ago that were not treated with the treatment that we have now. Because when we look at our brains, of course, the changes may also be a consequence of the treatment that these patients have received. And when we compare it maybe with the brains from the Odense Brain Bank, we can see whether these changes could be associated with the treatment or not, as those brains were not treated.